Hi everyone, Carol Brightbell. So did you ever feel like your browser could do more for you? Well, it can, thanks to Chrome extensions. Today I'm going to be showing you how to supercharge Google Chrome with these little tools. We'll cover what they are, how to find them and install them safely, and the best ones for productivity and fun. And I'll give you some pro tips on how to manage them. Stick around, this is going to transform your browser. And if you like this video, hit that subscribe button. Let's get started. So what is a Chrome extension? Think of it as an app for your browser. It's a small piece of software that adds new features or tweaks up how Chrome works. If you want to block ads, save articles, or even jazz up a new tab page, there's an extension for that. They live right in your browser, super easy to use, and they're a game changer for customizing your experience. So let's dive in and get started. Our first stop is the Chrome Web Store. You want to go to the three dot ellipse in the upper right corner and go down to Extensions and hover over that. You can see to the left where it says Visit the Chrome Web Store. Let's click on that, and now you're there. You'll see a search bar at the top, and when you scroll down, you'll see a lot of options for the top categories, editor's picks, accessibility extensions. A great one to search for is Grammarly. When you see that, select it. But before you select Add to Chrome, it's always very important to vet that extension. You want to see how many star rating it has, how widely used it is. If it's one that only has a 1-star rating and there's not many users, well, I think I'd steer clear of that extension. You can see Grammarly, though, has 47 million users and a 4.5 rating out of 42,000 ratings. So this is one I think would add value. You can select Add to Chrome. And before you select Add Extension, read what it has to say. And now it's loading the extension. Now I have to sign up. I'm going to sign up with Google. Finish your setup process and select Continue. So once you've installed an extension, how do you find that extension? When you look at the upper right, there's a little puzzle piece on your browser. And when you click that, it shows any extensions that you have installed. Here's the new Grammarly extension. If you hit the three dot ellipse beside that, it gives you more information about that browser. And this is also an easy way if you want to remove it from Chrome, if you don't want to use it anymore. Let me close this out. So now let's talk some must-have extensions. Of course, for productivity, Grammarly is a no-brainer. It catches typos and polishes your emails. If you're a shopper, you might want to try Honey. Honey has 17 million users. It's a 4.6 rating. It auto-applies coupon codes at checkouts. Another one you might want to look at for students is OneNote. With 1 million users, 4.8 rating, OneNote Clipper lets you save research straight to your notes. And for a gorgeous new tab, here's one that I think you'll really like. Momentum. 2 million users, 4.5 rating. What Momentum does, it replaces that boring page with a daily photo and a to-do list. I'm going to select Add to Chrome, Add Extension. Isn't that beautiful? Now, if you installed a lot of extensions, that's great, but you don't want them to pile up. Too many of them can slow down Chrome. When you head back to the three dot ellipse and you go back to extensions, now at the top here, it says manage extensions. When you're in this area, this is where you can turn those extensions on and off or remove those extensions. Yeah, and if Chrome starts lagging, it could be an extension that's doing it. So this is might be one of the places that you go along with clearing your cache and cookies. Let me go back to the Chrome Web Store because I want to also tell you that not all extensions are your friends. There are some sketchy ones out there that can track you or worse. So stick to well-known developers like Grammarly or Evernote and double-check permissions. If an extension is asking to do more than it needs to, like a weather app wanting your camera, pass. Google's gotten stricter, but you're your own first defense. If you're curious about a certain one, search its name. You know, you can come down, read the reviews. Just always take care of yourself. You're your first line of defense. And when you sign into Chrome with your Google account, all your extensions will sync across your devices, your laptop, your work PC, wherever. And that's it. Now you're a Chrome extension master. Install some, tweak up your setup, and if you have a favorite extension, please drop it in the comments. I'd love to hear it. And if you like this, please hit the button and subscribe for more tech tips. I'll catch you later. Have a great day.